Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Amen.
I want to take this opportunity to appreciate God for a chance to bring forth His word. And I also want us to put our hands together and appreciate our bishop and mom. Amen.
Amen.
I want us to put our hands together and welcome watu wa Shilo wamekuja ushago. Amen. We are so glad to have them around. Bwana asifiwe sana.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. The Lord is good, isn't He?
Mungu ni mwema.
The Lord is faithful, isn't He?
Mungu ni mwaminifu.
Amen. A story is told.
Habari ikasemwa.
Of it was a concert kind of competition.
Ilikuwa ni kama mashindano fulani.
Or an extravaganza.
Ama mambo ya muziki mahali.
And so people were given a song to sing.
Watu wakapewa wimbo kuimba.
And they would come one after another. The only constant thing was the band and the song.
Ilikuwa tu ni wimbo na kucheza vyombo, lakini watu walikuwa wanakuja mmoja kwa mwingine.
So people came and the song that they had been given was Amazing Grace.
Na wimbo ambao walikuwa wamepatia ni Amazing Grace.
We know Amazing Grace, isn't it?
Tunajua wimbo huu.
Amazing Grace. There it saved. Okay, I can see we know it. So everyone was coming and singing that particular song. And people walked on stage in majestic ways. And each of them would sing with skill. According to how they had been trained on their vocal techniques. And as each person would finish, the crowd would rise up, giving them a standing ovation and giving them a round of applause because they had done the song in a good way. Then suddenly, the last person who walked to the stage was a certain old man. And as he came to the stage, he did not have anything that was good to look at. And so he took the microphone. Amazing Grace. Not with very many vocal techniques. But by the time he finished the song, nobody stood to give a clap. Nobody celebrated. But people were on the floor wailing, crying, worshiping. Some were lying prostrate. Others were kneeling. Others were wailing while on the floor. Because the presence of God overwhelmed them.
Kwa sababu uwepo wa Bwana ulikuwa mwingi.
Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Let's read John chapter 4 verses 23 to 24. We are looking at worship as spiritual discipline.
Tunaangalia ibada kama kipengele cha kiroho.
Worship as spiritual discipline.
Ibada.
This is what the Bible says. Can we read it together to go? But the time is coming. Indeed, it's here now. When true worshippers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth, the Father is looking for those who will worship Him that way. For God is spirit, so those who worship Him must worship in truth. Let's go back to verse 23. Scripture begins by saying, the time is coming.
Maandiko yanaanza kusema wakati unakuja.
Indeed, it's here now.
Na sasa upo sasa.
In other words, as we are seated here this morning,
tunapoketi hapa asubuhi ya leo,
the time is already here.
Wakati umefika.
We are not waiting for the time.
Hatungojei muda.
It's already here now.
Iko hapa sasa.
And what is the time for?
Na wakati ni nini?
Bible says that it's the time when true worshippers, underline the word true, because wherever there is a true, then there is a false. So when true worshippers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth, the Father is looking for those who will worship Him that way. And so this morning, as we are standing in this place, the Father is looking for those who will worship Him in that way. He has not ceased looking for those ones who will worship Him in that manner. When you look at Psalms chapter 150, the Bible says, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. But when we come to John chapter 4 verses 23, the Father is looking for those who will worship Him in truth and in spirit. Meaning, getting people who are able to worship God in truth and spirit is rare. A story is told of a particular time when there was a church, a big church, a mega church. And in this mega church, they were planning for a worship experience. And they had put together a choir that was almost getting to 1,000 people. They had done auditions and picked the right kind of people vocally. They had invested in uniforms. They had the right instrumentalists. And so just about a day to the worship experience, the pastor of this mega church, as the story goes, passed on. And I'm thinking he could have passed on and then resurrected. Because I keep asking myself, who was there to tell the story? Because later on, he is the one who is telling the story. So he passed on. And he was taken by the Lord Jesus Christ. And so as they were walking around heaven and everything, he came to a point and he told Jesus, you know what? My church has a worship experience today and they are coming to worship
you.
It's a powerful choir, and so I'd like us to listen to them even when we are on this side of heaven. Praise the name of the Lord. And Jesus told him, as the story goes, we will listen to them as soon as it starts. Remember, the choir is of how many people? 1,000 people. And so when the time came, they sat somewhere, so the story goes. But as the worship started on earth, the pastor could only hear a voice of one person, one lady. He could not hear the instruments. He could not hear anything else. He was only able to hear one voice. And so he turned to Jesus and asked him, how come I can only hear the voice of so and so? And the Lord told him, because it's only so and so who is worshipping me in truth and in spirit. The rest are doing a showcasing of their talents. The rest are performing on that stage. The rest are shining so that their friends can see them. Turn to your neighbor and tell them, I pray that you will be the voice that will be heard today. Turn to the other one and tell them, I pray that as Jesus was listening to our worship this morning, He heard your voice. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And so what is worship? What is worship?
Ibada ni nini ama kuabudu ni kufanya nini?
Worship has always been considered as one of the items in the church program.
Ni mojawapo ya vipengele katika mipangilio ya kanisa.
And in most cases, if people don't really attach importance to it.
Na wakati mwingi watu hawaipatii maana.
Most of the people think that it is the part of the church program that starts off a church service. And so it's not so important. Therefore, I can be late in my house and come when the word is just about to start. I don't need to be there when worship is starting. Turn to your neighbor and ask them, what time did you come? In the tent, ask your neighbor, what time did you come? Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Now, worship is the art of giving reference to a supreme being, and in our case here, the supreme being is God. It is giving God the first place in our lives. Allowing him to have preeminence in our lives. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. It is giving God the first place in our lives. And so, if there is something else that you have given the first place in your life, that one is called idolatry.
Kama kuna kitu ambacho umekipatia sehemu ya kwanza maisha yako, hiyo ni kufanya kama miungu tu.
And many times we give many things a first place in our lives.
Mara mingi tunapeana vitu tofauti sehemu ya kwanza maisha yetu.
Worship is not good music.
Na ibada ama kuabudu sio muziki mzuri.
Even though good music enhances or helps us to worship.
Na pia muziki mzuri inatusaidia kuabudu.
So what do we mean here?
Tunamaanisha nini hapa?
That even without singing and music we can still worship.
Inamaanisha pia bila kuimba na kusikia muziki tunaweza kuabudu pia.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Even when your voice cannot be found on the keyboard.
Hata kama sauti yako haiwezi patikana katika mcheza kinanda.
Turn to your neighbor and ask them, can your voice be found on the keyboard?
Muulize sauti yako inaweza patikana pale.
Even if it can't be found on the keyboard, you can still worship because worship is not about song.
Na pia kama sauti haipatikani pale unaweza kuabudu kwa sababu kwa kuabudu sio tu kuimba.
The Bible says in Exodus chapter 20 verses 3.
Biblia inasema kutoka 20 mstari wa 3.
Do not worship any other gods besides me.
Usiabudu miungu mingine isipokuwa mimi.
And many times when we talk about that scripture,
tunapoongea kuhusu maandiko yale.
Because it's part of the 10 commandments.
Ni sehemu tu ya maamri 10.
Our minds quickly run to a carved image of sort.
Na mawazo yetu naenda katika vile vitu ambavyo vimechongwa.
But I want to bring it to you today,
lakini nataka kukuelezea leo,
that when we say do not worship other gods, many times even in the Christians of the current generation we have gods.
Na tunapowasema tusiabudu miungu mingine, hata Wakristo wa kizazi hiki pia wako na miungu.
They may not be carved,
haitakuwa michongo,
but there are those things that we have given the first place in our lives.
Lakini kuna yale mambo tumeyapatia sehemu ya kwanza ya maisha yetu.
Yesterday my husband was telling me, he happened to have visited a Hindu temple yesterday. And he was telling me that they were shown a number of gods in that temple. The Hindus have 330 million gods.
The
Lord Jesus. Can just put 330 million gods. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Now, decree and declare safety. We decree and declare protection in the mighty name of Jesus. Be exalted, Lord. We thank you for the nation of Kenya. They don't have a problem. They will include him there so that now they will have 331 million what? Gods. And you know, we may be laughing, but we could be having 5 gods, we could be having 10 gods, we could be having 20 gods. gods in our lives even as we are seated here today.
We have a
God we call our job. Whether it rains, cats or dogs, we will ensure we go to work. But when it is drizzling, we cannot come to church. Now that's a God. Praise the name of the Lord. We can have our spouses or our boyfriends as gods or our girlfriends as gods. Such that when there is a session of prayer on Monday or when there's a session of Bible study on Wednesday, then we are able to walk and say, no, I cannot come. I have married me a wife.
Kama kuna ibada Jumatatu ama Jumatano unasema siwezi kuja kwa sababu ni mchumba wangu na muhitaji.
I cannot come because I have children.
Siwezi kuja kwa sababu niko na watoto.
I cannot come to that prayer meeting which is only an hour on Monday because I have a business that I am running. That's a third God.
Siwezi kuja maombi kwa sababu niko na biashara nafanya hiyo masaa ya maombi.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
I cannot come because I am watching a series in the house. Do I have a witness?
Kwa sababu niko na series naona pale nyumbani.
I cannot come because the Premier League is on.
Siwezi kuja kwa sababu kuna EPL pale kwa tent.
How many gods have we counted so far?
Ni miungu ngapi ambayo
praise the name of the Lord. Now all those gods, they may not be 330 million, but most of us here have more than one. Praise the name of the Lord. The Bible says, do not worship any other gods besides
me.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Turn to your neighbor, muulize uko na Mungu ngapi?
Zing grace. And in
wako wangapi kwako?
How many do you have?
Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. I want us to just look at a few things here. In the book of Psalms,
but you know,
40 verses 3,
in our lives,
this is David who is writing and he is saying, let's read it together. He has put a new song in my mouth. Praise to our God. Many will see it and fear and will trust in the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
This was David, and he comes and he says, who has put the new song? The Lord God has put a new song in his mouth. Because God had done many things in his life. And when we look at this scripture, we discover two elements of worship. The first one is celebration. We are celebrating the Lord. It's a vertical dimension. We are celebrating God because of what he has done. He has put a new song in my mouth. And so even as I come to church on the 15th of September, as I woke up in the morning, I woke up with a new song in my heart. And the song was bubbling even before I came into this sanctuary. That song cannot be quenched because a worship team member has done an off key somewhere, and the worship team, that's not an excuse of worship
you in truth.
And so you're entering into the house of the Lord. And you're entering bubbling with praise in your heart. Because the Lord healed you that last week. Because when you were unwell, you called upon his name, he healed you. You called upon his name when you did not have food, he provided for you. He protected you against dangers that you knew and you did not know. And so you are saying, I am entering into the Lord's house with thanksgiving in my heart. Whether you come and find the worship team or not, your heart is bubbling with praise. Your heart is bubbling with worship because of that which he has done. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Now, when you are in this place, a space that David was in, you will discover that there won't be any chance. There won't be any chance where you can say that, Leo, we did not worship because your worship team ilikuwa imekauka. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
In
Jesus.
You won't say that that preacher didn't have the word.
Because as you entered, and as I entered, and as someone else entered, we were filled with praise. The Lord had already put a song in our hearts prior to us coming into this place. So whether there was song or not, I was ready to lift my hand and worship the King of Kings.
Kama kulikuwa kuna wimbo wa mapana nilikuwa tayari na bubujika na sifa ndani ya moyo wangu na ningeweza kuabudu tu.
That is what we call a celebration.
Hiyo ndio tunaita kusherehekea.
Ask your neighbor again, did the Lord put a song in your mouth before you came here this morning?
Muulize Mungu alikupea wimbo katika moyo mdomo wako kabla uje mahali hapa.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. The second dimension that we get from that scripture is what we call proclamation. You have already done celebration. You're celebrating the Lord. But as you are celebrating, you are also talking to the people. The Bible says, many will see it and fear. In other words, as I walked in and as I was celebrating the Lord and saying what the Lord has done, my neighbors got to know that I was healed. So they are able to see it and fear the Lord. In other words, my praise, my worship becomes infectious. That even though my neighbor walked in feeling low, because of the way I am praising, they will be infected with praise and they'll be infected with worship.
Jinsi na abudu na kusifu, pia wao wanatiwa moyo ya kufanya vile vile.
It is a proclamation.
Ni kutangaza.
Like the way we did amenitendea.
Yivo imba amenitendea.
All of us decided to start praising amenitendea.
Mmoja wetu akaimba vile vile.
Ask your neighbor, alikuwa amekutendea ukweli? Ama uliimba tu?
Had he done something for you or you're just singing because people were singing?
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Amenitendea. Hallelujah.
He has done it for me.
Amen.
Amen.
I want us to look back to the book of John chapter 4.
Turudie kitabu cha Yohana.
John chapter 4 verses 19 to 20.
Mstari wa 19 hadi 20.
And I want us to see a few things that could hinder our worship that we need to deal with so that we can worship effectively. Verse 19 says, Sir, this is Jesus talking to the Samaritan woman, and the Samaritan woman is responding back and saying, Sir, the woman said, you must be a prophet. So tell me, why is it that you Jews insist that Jerusalem is the only place of worship, while we Samaritans claim it is here at Mount Gerizim where our ancestors worshipped? Praise the name of the Lord. They have spoken back and forth. Jesus has spoken back and forth to this woman, and the woman acknowledges the fact that Jesus is a prophet. But she has a question. How come that the Israelites are talking that Jerusalem is the only place of worship, while her, coming from the Samaritan culture, they are saying that they can only worship at Mount Gerizim? Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And many times as Christians,
na wakati mwingi kama wa Kristo,
these are some of the strongholds that we hold that cause us not to worship.
Hivi ni vipengele ambazo tunaangalia ambazo zinafanya tusiweze kuabudu.
And so we need to reject some of these strongholds.
So lazima tukatae misingi kama hiyo.
There are times when we attach worship to good music, worship to good instruments.
Kuna wakati tunasema ibada lazima iwe na muziki mzuri ama ni vyombo vizuri.
Now that is a stronghold.
Hiyo ni kipingamizi.
It will hinder you from worship. worshiping.
Itakuzuia ushinde kumwabudu.
Assuming you went up country and you entered into this church that does not have equipment like what the Lord has blessed us with here.
Ukenda pale gishagi upate kanisa ambalo halina vyombo kama vyetu pale.
Will you worship effectively?
Je, utamwabudu Mungu?
Or will you sit in your house because there is no drum like what we are having here? Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
I want to bring it to you that even if you walked into that church where the darama, you know that darama that Kikuyus normally? That one. Even in that, the presence of God can still move.
Hata katika sehemu kama ile, uwepo wa Mungu utakuwa pale.
If you get to where I come from, where we normally do the electric claps, do I have people from my community in the house? We clap in an electric way. You don't need electricity for that clap to be heard. Even there, the presence of the Lord is.
Hata makofi ya aina hiyo, uwepo wa Mungu uko pale.
In other words, we are not going to attach our worship to houses of worship and events.
Ya kwamba hata ulinganisha ibada yetu kwa Mungu na vitu vya kawaida tu.
It is good the Lord has blessed us with a magnificent cathedral.
Ni vizuri Mungu ametupatia hekalo nzuri.
But even if we were to meet outside there as a person and you, your heart is filled with a song, you can still be able to raise a worship to the King of Kings. Nje
na moyo wako uko na wimbo mpya utaweza kumwabudu Mungu pale.
You can still raise a worship in your house.
Unaweza pia fanya ibada ama maabudio katika nyumba yako.
Because the Lord has done it for you. You wake up in the morning with your heart filled with a song and you break out into a dance.
Kwa sababu Mungu amekutendea unaamka asubuhi na bubujika na furaha ya moyo na Mungu amekupatia wimbo.
It may be a single room.
Inaweza kuwa ni kichumba kimoja tu.
But in that small space you can still lift your hands and tell him, Father, see how far you have brought me.
Unaweza inua mikono yako na usambie Mungu tazama jinsi ambazo umenileta.
It might be a mabati house.
Inaweza kuwa ni nyumba ya mabati pia.
But Father, see how far you have brought me.
Lakini
as you wait for him to take you to the blessings that he has promised.
Unapongojea kupeleka katika viwango vingine vya juu.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And so we must come to a point of rejecting the strongholds that make us not worship the Lord.
Lazima tufike mahali tukatae misingi ambayo inatuzuilia tuweze kumwabudu Mungu.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Amen.
The second thing that we must realize in worship, you recognize the Savior, Jesus as the Savior.
Katika kuabudu lazima umtambue Kristo kama mwokozi.
In John chapter 4 verses 26.
Mstari wa 26 wa Yohana mlango wa 4.
John chapter 4 verses 26. The Bible says that after conversing, this woman ultimately recognizes that this man is not an ordinary man. And he says, then Jesus told her, I am the Messiah. Jesus introduces himself to the woman, I am the Messiah.
Yesu anajitangulisha kwa ule mwanamke ya kwamba mimi ni Messiah.
After Jesus has exposed the false assumptions of worship, he guides the Samaritan woman into an amazing recognition of his glory and his mission to save.
Baada kumwelekeza anajitanguliza na kujionyesha yeye ndio Messiah.
Turn to your neighbor and ask them, do you know Jesus is the Messiah?
Je, unamfahamu Yesu ndiye Messiah?
Do you have a relationship with him?
Je, uko na uhusiano na yeye?
Now, true worship erupts in the soul of one who understands that Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin.
Ibada ya kweli yule ambaye anafahamu ya kwamba Yesu ni mwanakondoo wa Mungu ambaye anatuondolea dhambi.
You can only worship that which you know.
Unaweza abudu tu kile ambacho unakifahamu.
And so when you know him as the Messiah, your worship will be different to him.
Unapomjua kama Mesia, ibada yako ama maabudu yako itakuwa ya kipekee.
When you know him as the Messiah, nobody will push you to come in to church at 10 a.m. when the service is beginning because you know you're not coming into a program. You are going to worship him whom you are in love with.
Unapomfahamu yeye ni nani, hautasukumwa kuja kanisa mapema, lakini utakuja kufahamu ya kwamba unakuja kumwabudu yule ambaye unamjua.
In other words, worship becomes your love language to Jesus Christ.
Ya kwamba ibada ama kuabudu inakuwa ni sehemu mpendeleo yako, uhusiano wako wa karibu na Kristo.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
When you know that he is the Messiah, you walk inside that door and you remove every credential and put it down. Your CEO kofia, you put it down. Your prophetic whatever, you put it down. And you come to him as a child of God.
Unapomtambua yeye ni nani, unapoingia mahali hapa, unashusha tajriba zako zote. zote na unakuja kwake kama mtoto wake.
He remains as the king.
Yeye ndiye mfalme.
He remains as the Lord.
Yeye ndiye Bwana.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
He is the Messiah.
Yeye ni Messiah.
Tell your neighbor, he is the Messiah.
Mwambie yeye ni Messiah.
And here where you are seated, I do not care what position you are holding anywhere. He is the king in this house.
Yeye ni mfalme, ijapokuwa uko na tajriba zako, yeye ni mfalme.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number three.
Ya tatu.
Worship. For worship to be effective, you must come to a point of repenting your sin.
Lazima ufike wakati wa kutubu dhambi zako.
John chapter 4 verses 16 to 18. John chapter 4 verses 16 to 18. It says, Jesus now addresses, he has already dealt with the assumptions of worship. He has already started introducing himself. Now he delves into another dimension where he's saying, go and get your... Go and get your husband. 17. I don't have. The woman replied. Jesus said, you're right. You don't have a husband. For you have had. And you aren't even married to the man you're living with now. You certainly spoke the truth. When you come into the presence of the Lord,
unapokuja katika uwepo wa Bwana,
he points out things in your life.
Anagusisha mambo katika maisha yako.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Because he knows everything.
Kwa sababu anayafahamu yote.
You cannot worship God effectively and still continue hiding sin.
Hauwezi mwabudu Mungu kwa ukweli kama bado unaficha dhambi.
You cannot be a worshipper and continue walking in sin.
Hauwezi kuwa wewe ni mtu wa ibada na bado unatembea katika dhambi.
And imagine that God doesn't know.
Na unafikiria kwamba Mungu hafahamu.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
You cannot be in the worship team. You are worshiping, but last night you slept somewhere.
Hauwezi kuwa uko hapa unaabudu na kumbe jana ulikuwa kwingine.
What you have become, even if you sing as beautiful as what, all that you've been reduced to is a song leader.
Na kila ambacho umefanyika kuwa tu wewe ni mwongozi tu wa wimbo lakini sio ibada.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord Jesus, who knows all things, did not assume that this woman was married.
Na Yesu ambaye anajua mambo yote hakutaka tu kuamini kwamba huyu mwanamke alikuwa ameoleka.
And Jesus guides her to confess and repent her sin.
Na Yesu akamuelekeza ili aweze kukiri na kutubu dhambi zake.
The Bible talks in the book of Isaiah chapter 6 from verse 1. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord.
Wakati mfalme Uzia alikufa nilimuona Bwana.
He was sitting on a lofty throne and the train of his robe filled the temple. Then verse 2. Attending him were mighty seraphim, each having 6 wings. With 2 wings they covered their faces, with 2 they covered their feet, and with 2 they flew. They were calling out, holy, holy, holy is the Lord of heaven's armies. The whole earth is filled with his glory. Their voices shook the temple to its foundation, and the entire building was filled with smoke. 5. Then I said, it's all over. I am doomed, for I am a sinful man. I have filthy lips and I live among a people with filthy lips, yet I have seen the King, the Lord of heaven's armies. Isaiah, from chapter 1 to chapter 5, he has been a prophet.
Isaiah mlango wa kwanza hadi tano, yeye ni nabii.
He has been prophesying.
Alikuwa akitoa unabii ndio.
But when he gets into the presence of the Lord where worship is,
alipofika katika uwepo wa Mungu penye kuna
maabudu, suddenly he discovers that he is a man who of unclean lips.
Anakumbuka yeye ni mtu mwenye midomo michafu.
He discovers that he is a sinner.
Yeye anatambua yeye ni mtenda dhambi.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Isaiah was not a drunkard from an alcohol den.
Isaiah hakuwa mlevi ule.
He was a servant.
Yeye alikuwa ni mtumishi.
And there are many times we could be in the presence of the Lord. We are serving in the house of the Lord. We are Christians. We come to church.
Kuna wakati mwingi sisi tunashiriki katika meza ya Bwana, tunafanya mambo katika kanisa lakini.
But how I pray that we would be able to get into the presence of the Lord so that he can unearth who we are in his presence. Because suddenly when you come face to face with him, you are able to see his holiness, and all that we will be able to say is, woe unto me, for I am undone. And when we are undone, the only way we can be able to survive in the presence of God is through repentance. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
It's only through repentance. Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And so Isaiah says, woe unto me because I am undone. Worship causes us to be able to see our sin and to repent of the same. Worship, number four, should be surrounded by scripture. In other words, it should be scriptural. We cannot worship out of scripture.
Hatuwezi abudu tu isipokuwa kulingana na maandiko.
Why? Because scripture reveals to us the true nature of God.
Kwa sababu maandiko yanatuonyesha jinsi Mungu alivyo.
It's through scripture that we get to know who exactly Jesus is.
Ni kupitia kwa maandiko tunafahamu Yesu ni nani.
It reveals to us the nature of God.
Inatufunulia ukuu wa Mungu ama uhali wa Mungu.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Worship therefore, because we have said music enhances our worship, therefore even the music that we do should be surrounded with scriptures.
Hata muziki ambao tunaufanya lazima uambatane na maandiko.
Not just contemporary songs. That because you've heard it in every matatu, you've heard it in every TV station, therefore you are saying this is the latest, let us go and sing it. Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We should subject it to the scriptures before we can sing it.
Lazima tuipime na maandiko kabla kuimba.
That's why you realize that there were songs that were sung in olden days by old people. Some of them have already gone to be with the Lord, yet they are still very powerful even today.
Na niposa kuna nyimbo ambazo ziliimbwa kale sana, lakini bado zikiimbwa wakati huu ziko na uwezo na nguvu.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Blessed assurance, Jesus. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. It was sung by our forefathers. We sing it today. It still bears the power. At the cross where I first saw the light. It never fades.
How is she?
It still carries with it power. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Because it was surrounding scripture.
Kwa sababu umezingirwa na maandiko.
But what are we doing? What are we doing in the current dispensation?
Wakati huu tunafanya nini?
Because it has been in every radio station, we find ourselves bringing it in the house of God. We find ourselves dancing to it. But the question is it scriptural?
Je, umeipima na maandiko?
Anguka nayo. Unaanguka ukienda wapi?
You are dropping going where?
Yet the Bible says that we have been raised and seated with Christ in heavenly
places.
Ananipenda leo kuliko jana. Jesus loves us the same. He is the same yesterday, today, and
hawezi kunipenda
leo kuliko lini?
He cannot love me today more than yesterday.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
He is just a carpenter. No, he is the son of the living God.
Yeye ni mwana wa Mungu aishie.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And so even when we are singing in church, we need to first and foremost check these lyrics that we are doing. The beat could be wonderful. The rhythm could be wonderful. It could be up to date today. But is it scriptural?
Je, umeipima na maandiko?
Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Amen.
Because many times we ask ourselves, why isn't God moving in our midst? Who are we praising?
Mara mingi tunajiuliza mbona Mungu hatembei katika mambo yetu? Je, tunamwabudu nani?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What happened to the songs? So I'll cherish the old rugged cross. What happened?
Nini nitendeka kwa nyimbo kama hizo?
Many times when someone comes and sings that song here, you see people looking at the worship team like this. You know, apart from the old generation, akina bishop na mam, the rest of the people are looking like this. They are waiting for the one where they will be able to dance, swing their waist until they are sweating. And after they have sweat, you ask them out there what Jesus did in their lives. Nothing. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
We need to go back to the old time religion.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The young people in the house, we must go down back to the old time religion. You need a touch from him.
Tunahitaji uguso wake.
You need a healing from him.
Unahitaji uponyaji wake.
He can only be where his glory is.
Anaweza kuwa tu pale ambapo utukufu wake upo.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We cannot force him to come. We must build a resting place where he will be comfortable in.
Hatuwezi mlazimisha, lazima tutengeneze makazi ambayo atafurahia kukua pale.
That comes when we reject the strongholds.
Hiyo inafanyika tunapokataa pingamizi.
When we acknowledge him as savior.
Tunapomtambua kama mwokozi.
When we repent our sin.
Tunapotubu dhambi zetu.
And when we worship the scriptural way.
Na tunapomwabudu jinsi maandiko yanapotuelekeza.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Amen.
An old woman could enter in this place, I am wondering. It could, an old woman or an old man can enter into this place. And they just begin with a kerosho.
You know? Tu kwa lugha yake.
Niene joy. Nege naga. And you know, that's all they might come and do here. They might just come and do niwara nono. Bwana sifiwe. And as they do that, the presence of God just comes down. There won't be anything contemporary about it. Yet again, as I get out of your way, what of your private worship? Ask your neighbor, do you have a time of private worship? And maybe you're saying, I don't have time. I want you to know that worship is a lifestyle. As you're balancing those books in the office because you are an accountant and you're doing them well, you're not doctoring the figures, that is a worship. As you're teaching those children, that is a worship. As you're making food for your family ladies, that is a worship. Everything that surrounds you and I should be a worship. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
We won't say that worship is only when we have set time aside. Ati kwa sababu mchungaji alisema we have to worship even in the in our workplaces. Therefore, the boss hears you screaming at the top of your voice. That is not what we are saying, brethren.
Hatusemi uanze kupiga kelele kazini ya kwamba unaabudu.
You can still be working and worshiping.
Unaweza kuwa ukifanya kazi na bado ukiabudu.
Because that is one of the disciplines that God would have us to have in our lives.
Kwa sababu hiyo ni moja wapo ya vipengele ambavyo Mungu anahitaji tuwe navyo katika.
When you worship him, he comes.
Anapomwabudu yeye hushuka.
When we worship him, he touches you.
Tunapomwabudu yeye anatugusa.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
I'll put you in front of my melody. You are all that matters. You are all that matters. I'll make room for two. You and I, Jesus, you are all that matters. You are all that matters. I'll put you in front of my melody. You are all that matters. You are all that matters. I'll make room for two. praise today. We honor you, Jesus. We worship you. We thank you because you're mighty, our Father. We choose to make room for two only, oh God, that we will lock ourselves in with you, Jesus, to worship you because you are all that matters. We thank you, our Father. We give you praise. Maybe you're there this morning and you do not know the Lord. I'd like us together to repeat this prayer. Say, Lord Jesus, I come to you. I've discovered that I do not know you as the Messiah. And today I've heard your word. I pray that you'd come into my heart and make a habitation in me. That it will be you and I, Jesus, because it's you that matters. Save me today. Save me today and lead my life in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for saving me in Jesus' name.